Hello guys, this is Vivek here. Welcome to my channel. Today in this video we are going to discuss upon touch potential and step potential, one of the most important questions that has been asked a number of times to me. Before that I would say sorry to all of you because I was not able to upload videos regular, or I was not on this channel because I was busy with some of my works, but anyway that is over now. So I will try to bring these informative videos, more informative sessions, more and more regular. So thank you all for supporting me, and I hope that you all keep supporting me like this, because that encourages me to bring these videos for you. Okay, so let's just start with our today's topic. So touch potential and step potential. The name itself is self-explanatory. Okay, touch potential means that if you touch something, you get some electric shock. That is what called touch potential, and exactly what it is. Let's say there is a transmission line between these two points. Okay, and the electric current is flowing through this in this direction. Now all of a sudden, because of some problem, this snaps. Okay, so what will happen? Two things will happen. Either the wire will fall directly on the ground. This is the ground. Okay, so it might fall on the ground directly. Or what can happen? Let's say some plant or some tree or some object is over here, like let's say some car can be there, so it can fall upon this. Okay, so this this is what the point, or this is what the fault to which both of these terms, touch potential and step potential, are related. So first of all we discuss about the touch potential. Now what happens in the touch potential? Let's say some person is standing over here, okay, some standing over here, or inside this car, or here he or she is standing. Now he touches this object, okay, upon which the wire has fallen, he touches this object. So obviously what will happen, the electric current that was flowing through the transmission line will now flow through this, through his or her body. Okay, so this is what called touch potential. He will or she will face an electric shock. Okay, so this is what called touch potential. That is, you touch something through which electric current is flowing. Why the electric current is flowing? The electric current is flowing because the electric conductor that is carrying very high current, and I must mention that this is a transmission line, so obviously it might be up from 25 kV to 800 kV. It can be any kind of line. So the electric current is flowing through this line, and the person that is standing adjacent to that object touches that, or touches the metallic surface or something that is connected to the ground. So the electric current will find a short path through his or her body, and that is what called touch potential. Okay, that is the voltage that across the human body that is there is called the touch potential. Now let us talk about step potential. Let me rub this first of all. Now what is this step potential? We again go to our same example, like let's say this transmission line has snatched, okay, and it has fallen upon some car. First of all we consider this, that there is some car standing over here, and the potential, the car has this wire has stuck on this car. Now if you are inside the car, if the person that is driving the car is inside the car, he or she will be safe, and he or she should remain within the car, okay, because then you will not be directly affected due to this electric shock, because the current will flow directly to the ground and it will not pass through your body. Now two cases are here. Either you can be is within the car at till the time someone comes up and make this wire get away from your car, or if you want to walk away from the car, so what you can do, just open the gate of your car very carefully and start traveling on the other side by jumping like a rabbit. Okay, how does a rabbit jumps? A rabbit jumps with both his leg together. Okay, that is, let's say how a person walks. A person walks like this, one step behind the another step. Okay, but in this case, what you need to do is that you need to jump with both of your legs together. Okay, up to 10 meters. Okay, up to 10 meters from the point of fall. Like this is the point of fall, this is the point of fall. So from here, you walk up to 10 meters. Up to 10 meters by jumping with both your legs together like a rabbit. Okay, why I'm saying this? Let me rub this on. Because what happens if, let's say, some fault has happened over here. Okay, some fault has happened. So up to 10 meters. Up to 10 meter radius, okay, from the point of fault, the fault current can flow. Okay, the fault current can flow and hence the effect can be seen. That is, it's not that if you are not in the contact of this direct point, then you will not get an electric shock. Even if you are within this 10 meter range and walking with both your legs like this, so what will happen? Let's say one leg is on this point and another is here. With each step, 10 kilovolts of voltage drop happens. So let's say if there is a 800 kV line, approximately I'm saying, so if there's an 800 kV line, so 10 kV drop, so this point will be 790, this one, okay, this will be 780, this will be 770, so it will, at least there is a 10 kV difference between each and every ring, and we do not exactly know that what is the distance between each ring, but approximately it has been seen that up to 10 meters the voltage keeps on falling with 10 kV per ring. Okay, it can be greater, it can be smaller, but for our example we consider that this is 10 kV. Now what will happen if one of your step is on this ring and another is on this ring, like if you are walking like this one, so what will happen? The difference between each of your step will be 10 kV. So as a result, because there is a potential difference between both of your legs, that is 10 kV, a huge amount of electric current will flow through your body and you will feel electric shock, which may cause organ failure as well as death. Okay, so it is very much important that you take both of your steps together, so that what will happen with that, that if both of your steps are together on a ring, so the potential difference, like let's say if it is 80 kV over here and 80 kV over here, so the potential difference will be 0 kilovolts. Okay, so or in practical sense, there might be few volts or few microvolts that you will feel, but that will be not much of danger, or that will be not much dangerous, because your body can sustain within that voltage range. Okay, so there is a 0 kilovolt difference of potential between both of your states, and hence you do not feel any fatal electric shock. So this is what called step potential. So you should always keep this in mind, because most of our workers or people that are working in hazardous area, they are trained to do this kind of things, and they follow all these guidelines. So it is because of the same reason, because this step potential can be very fatal. As you can see, it's not like the wire has fallen over here, so if you are away from this region then you are safe. No, it is a very high voltage line, because automatically you can understand that the transmission line can somewhere range between 25 kV to 800 kV or even more. Okay, in today's date we are increasing the voltage ranges, so there can be any high voltage, and this is a very high voltage. So you should always keep this in mind, that when you are walking away from the point of accident, both of your legs should be together on each and every time. Try to walk up to at least 10 meters. Okay, 10 meters, not less than this. Okay, at least 10 meters with your rough estimate, or that is, you walk away as far as possible from the point of accident, and then you can walk normally. So I hope in this video I cleared the touch potential and step potential. I tried to make this video easy for all of you, and this was one of the very important questions that I was getting every time, that there should be a clarity upon all these terms that we use, the touch potential, the step potential, because most of the time these are asked in different interviews or exams as well. So I hope this video cleared all that concepts about touch and step potential. If this video was helpful for you, please do not forget to subscribe, share this video with your friends, and like this video. And if you have any suggestion or if you have any question or problem, you can put them in the comment section below. I will answer all that question and all that queries, and share this video with your friends, because that motivates me to make such informative videos for all of you. And thank you for supporting me. Thank you for being on this channel for this long. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.